Hi there, your computer friend Connie here. Do you have an existing SharePoint site and would like to link it or link pages of it to your Teams? Well, I'm going to show you how to do that. And there's actually six different things I'm going to show you within SharePoint that we can link back into Teams. And also in this video, I'd like to talk to you about permissions. What happens with the permissions when you're doing that? So stay tuned for the whole video to see all this information. So let's start with what's in front of us. This is the instructor's SharePoint site. Let's say I want to have this page available to people in another one of my teams within Teams. So I'm just going to grab the URL at the top here, copy that. And from within Teams, I've gone to the mission training team and the general channel. So I want to have that SharePoint site available from here. So I'm going to go to the plus sign at the top. Now they have two choices to go with. I can either add it as SharePoint or as a website. Either choice, I'm going to need to use the URL that I copied. So let's use SharePoint for this first example. Now, when I first go in here, because I'm in the mission training team, it's only giving me stuff about that particular team, which really, if you know anything about Microsoft Teams, then you understand that Microsoft Teams really uses SharePoint as its back end for saving the files. So it's always using a SharePoint site. But I want to take this team and link it to really another team, or in this case, another SharePoint site and the entire page of it. So I'm going to choose any site. And then this is where I can paste in that link that I copied. I can choose to post this to the channel so everybody knows I've done it. I'm going to turn that off though, and then save. And there you see, within the mission training team, which is a completely different area, I can see my instructor's information. So I'm going to change the name of this tab at the top so it reflects it a little bit better. And then once we have this site open, if we click on the folders on the left, let's say, that will take us into the file. So we really have access to everything that this site has to offer. So we don't need to go to the browser to find our SharePoint site when we have Teams available to us to make the shortcut. All right, for our next example, I want to just bring in an area of SharePoint that houses some of the files that I want to access in one of my teams. And it's a different team than the SharePoint site itself. So this mission marketing is a team that has a number of folders of files that I'd like to access from my instructor team. So what I can do is really the same thing I just did before, is I can, first of all, when I'm in the SharePoint site, the mission marketing site, I navigate it to documents on the left. And then once I'm in documents on the left, I'm just going to grab the URL from the top again. So copy that. And then this time I want to take that information that came from mission marketing, that SharePoint site, and put it into the instructor's team so I can access it there. So I want to take the files from a different SharePoint site, which also could be a different team if that's how it was created, and see them in one of my other teams. So just, it's really like a shortcut. I can see those files from either direction. I can either go to that SharePoint site or that team, or I can stay in the team that I'm always in and access it there. So really more, we're doing this for convenience. So I'm clicked on general here. I'm gonna hit the plus sign again at the top. Again, I can go SharePoint as we did in the last example, but I'm going to choose website this time just so you can see that it really will give us very similar results. There's a bit more flexibility when I choose this though. I'll choose that. It's good to experiment with the two options to see how they're a little bit different. It's giving me the option right at the beginning here to put a name to this tab rather than me having to rename it later. So I'm taking marketing documents and putting them into my instructor's team. So let's just say that. And let's paste in the URL. We don't need to post to the channel, and save it. So later on in the video, what we'll do is we'll address the permissions part of it, because I am taking information from one area to another. And within those areas, so SharePoint sites or teams, there could be different memberships, there could be different permissions. So I'm going to talk to you about how those permissions are going to translate across. So right now, I'm just showing you how to do it, and then we'll talk about permissions as the second part of it. Now I do want to bring in some more documents into my instructor site, but again, they're going to be from a different SharePoint site. And in this example, it's actually going to come from a different document library. So if you're not clear on what a document library is within SharePoint, then check out one of my other videos that explains that to you. So I'm going to go out of Teams and go back to SharePoint. So I'm back in SharePoint. I'm in a different site called Human Resources. And I have on the left-hand side something called draft policy. Okay, so draft policy, you know what I'm gonna do. I'm just gonna go to the URL at the top and I'm gonna copy it like I've done in the other examples. Go back to Teams, hit the plus sign again. And we used website last time. Let's use SharePoint this time. So I don't want the document library isn't within instructors. It's coming from a different SharePoint site. So I'm gonna go any SharePoint site and then I'm gonna paste in the link there. Turn off posting to channels, save it. All right, now I know I only have a couple of examples of files in here, but just pretend this has hundreds of files or it even can have folders as well. So look at the difference here. This is a document library for draft policy. When someone's in here, that's the only place they can be. I mean, if I had more folders, they can go into folders, but they can only go into these files. Now let's go to marketing docs, which is another area that I link to. And when someone's in marketing docs, they have pretty much free range of going into any of these folders, right? So they can go into that folder and then they can go in there. And then they can kind of go back out by clicking on each of the, so I can kind of go up a level, go back to documents, go into online biz. And even if I went, what I could have done as my example actually was grab maybe the address for online biz so that when I went to marketing documents, it was showing this area. But even if I did that, when someone comes here, they can still go documents and go up a level. Whereas draft policy, there's no way for them to go up a level. They can't kind of look around. They're just there, right? And they're just there looking at whatever you want. So document library becomes a way of you maybe containing those documents a bit more securely. Okay, for our next example, I want to take a page. So not the opening page of a SharePoint site, but just one of the pages within a SharePoint site that I have and link that to my team. So there's maybe a page that's frequented by that particular team, and rather than having to go to the SharePoint with it through the browser or through some other shortcut, they can just have it available to them right within the team. So I'm in mission marketing. If I click on home, you'll see that the home page is different, right? So this is the home page of the site. And if I go to marketing training, let's say, then this page is different, right? So that's what I'm talking about. I just want them to go to this page. I don't need them to go to the home page of the site. I just want them to have access to this one page. So I'm gonna grab that URL again. Such a handy thing. And back in Teams, let's add another tab to our instructor's team. So I could be going into different channels, by the way, within my instructor's team. I'm just using general as my example here, but just keep that in mind when you are placing these shortcuts to SharePoint pages or files, where should they go within the team that you're placing them? What channel should they go in? So I'm gonna hit the plus sign here and we'll say website this time. And I put my tab name in there and my URL and save it. All right, so now I can see that page, right? But I can't get to any other pages. So notice, as opposed to that original one that we did where we could see the whole site, this one only lets us see one page of the SharePoint site. Now, the reason I'm showing you these methods of linking to from SharePoint to Teams is because I'm assuming someone set up a SharePoint site for you, and now you have Teams and you're wondering, well, how do I get people to use Teams and access my SharePoint site as well? This could be a way of integrating the two things. So that way you're linking the Teams with the SharePoint site and you're not making people go to Teams and then go to SharePoint and then go to Teams and then go to SharePoint. You're having one place. Have them go into Teams, and then from Teams, they get into the SharePoint pages that you already had created. Okay. All right. Another thing that could have been created on a SharePoint site for you that you want to have access to within Teams is lists. Maybe there is a list set up somewhere that has some really good information that you don't want to have to always go out of Teams to get. So let's link this in there as well. So I'm going to take this list that comes from instructors, and I'm gonna link it to a different team that I have. So I'm gonna grab the URL, copy it, and this time I'm gonna go to the mission marketing team, the general channel there, and at the top there, I'm gonna add in that list. All right, so see how nice that is? Now I can just have it actually quickly available to me, and I can even work on it from here. I don't have to open it up within SharePoint to work on it. I can look at it from here or I can work on it from here. Okay, the last example that's quite popular for people to want to have access to from their SharePoint site is that maybe they have some kind of SharePoint centralized calendar for the company or the organization, and they want to have access to that calendar within Teams so they can see when things are happening. So we can take that page that has the calendar on it and we can copy it into the team. So let's do that. Grab the URL again. And I'm going to go back to my instructor's general channel, and I'm going to add in that calendar. Let's use SharePoint again here. So this is a live calendar coming from SharePoint. So even though I'm in Teams, I can still work with it in here. So now let's talk about permissions from all the things that we added in. So every example that I gave you assumed that we were using private groups or teams. And what that means is it's private, so it's locked down to certain membership, as opposed to being public to your entire organization. So if it's public, then the permissions are different than what I'm going to suggest to you here. So let's go back to one of our first examples. The first example I had for you was a mission marketing site. And I'm back on that site now. Click on home. So I want you to see on the right hand side of the site, it is saying private group first off. And the next thing I want you to notice is how many members. So if I click on members, you'll see there's only 3 members. And the member that's missing is the one called info@mission-computers.com. And so that's the one we're going to test out together, as I'm obviously the Connie Clark member right now. So there is no info member here. And what I've done with this site is I've connected the folders from this site to instructors. Now let's go back to Teams and instructors. Let's look at, I'm just gonna open up the membership there, manage the team. And so Connie Clark again is there with that same picture. And if we go to members and guests here, you're gonna see there's a second Connie, and that's my other account that I'm testing this with. That actually, as I hover on it, it's showing you that that account is info@mission-computers. So it's a different email address, right? So this is a different person is what I want you to think of here. So this person was not in the mission marketing SharePoint site. There was not a member of that. So does that mean that even though you linked the marketing documents that they weren't a member of into instructors, which they are a member of, can they see it? Okay, let's take a peek. So I'm gonna go to general. So from general, I have marketing docs. This is where I linked in that marketing SharePoint site, and or the info@mission-computers does not have permission. So this is what you need to understand, is that linking is great, but it has to make sense that the permissions follow through. And this could work to your benefit, because maybe you're saying, well, that's okay. I still wanted everybody else that did have permissions to see it, to see it. So in the team, info, that we'll call this person info for now. Info is a member of the instructor team. So they're seeing this tab called marketing docs. But when they go to it, that says, hey, you don't have permission. You can ask for permission, but you don't have it. So that's where you want to know that the linking is not giving people extra permissions. It's just letting your permissions flow if that is what makes sense. Okay, let's test out a couple of other scenarios here. So another example that we had was I went from the instructor site to the mission training team. And you can see mission training is a team that I have access to here, and I have access to instructors. So whatever I linked, I should be able to see, right? That would make sense. So if I go to general here, instructor site is showing there. So that's the SharePoint site for it. And it is showing, right? Because that makes sense. I have access to both those teams. I'm obviously a member of both of them. I can see them both. So my permissions are flowing through properly here. Now, another one I did was the human resources one. And again, you can see human resources is showing on the left-hand side. I put some stuff from human resources, that SharePoint site, and I gave it access to instructors again. So if I go back to instructors, I think one of the ones I linked there from human resources was draft policy. So let's click on that. And because I have access to that team, I'm going to assume I have access to this document library.
but I don't. Okay. Yeah. So this is another example of, I can see the human resources team from here, but draft policy was a special kind of files area. It was a document library. And one of the special things about it is that it can have separate permissions from the entire SharePoint site or the entire team for that matter. From what you see here, this is telling us that in fact, the info member does not have access to these files. So another reason why that document library is a bit more secure for us. Okay, and another one that we added in from HR or human resources was calendar. So let's go there. This is group calendar. So I do have access to that because that's part of the main part of the SharePoint site. So permissions within Teams and SharePoint, there's a lot of options for you in how you secure your information for your group so the right group of people sees the right information. And linking stuff is also a really great option for you. It's just you do have to keep in mind what the permissions are from site to site or area to area. So you have a bit more accessibility and one place to go to get to other things that you need. Thanks. Have fun with that.